Good morning, Corona. I'm Connor McAlpine.
And I'm Matt Austin.
And this is CDS TV.
Give me your secrets, bring me a sign. Give me a reason to walk the fire. See another dawn through a daughter's eyes. You give me a reason to walk the fire.
Hey, Corona. If you're a junior and a Tempe resident, pick up an application to be part of Tempe's sister cities in room E260.
See Ms. Cagle in the guidance office for more information on the cosmetology program at EVIT.
Hey, the leadership seminar is this Saturday. Registrations are due today. Pick up a form in the guidance or activities office.
Students, what do you do when your zombie is chasing you? Come see Advanced Acting and Directing Ensemble tomorrow night at 7 p.m. for Pom-Pom Zombies in the auditorium.
Hey, speaking of Pom-Pom Zombies, I got a chance to sit down with Connor McAlpine, a member of the cast. Let's go to my interview with Connor McAlpine. Connor? Hi, I'm Connor McAlpine, here in studio with Connor McAlpine. Connor, I hear there's this new play coming up. Can you tell me a little bit about it, please?
The next play coming up is called Pom Pom Zombies, and it is a collaboration between the two advanced acting and directing classes, and it will be in the big auditorium on November 15th, 16th, and 17th. It's about a seaside town and their high school students, and their favorite hot dog stand ends up being infected with some mutagenic relish, and all the cheerleaders turn into zombies.
Excellent.
Hence the name.
What kind of genre is the play?
Genre. Well, it is definitely a comedy. Many good laughs, but also we have quite a few musical numbers. So definitely a musical comedy. Excellent.
Superb. Now, if you had to describe the play in just one word, what would that word be?
One word. I would have to say super wonderiferous, which comes, of course, from the Latin root, meaning this play is going to be really good. Lots of laughs, lots of fun, great dance numbers, people in drag. Let me tell you, it's going to be a wonderful feat.
Excellent.
Theatrical amazement.
Well, there you have it, Corona. Pom Pom Zombies in the Main Stage Theater on the 15th, 16th, and 17th. Back to me in the studio. Thanks for that, Connor. Always looking sharp.
There will be a Red Cross meeting next Tuesday after school in room E072. New members are always welcome. Attention juniors and seniors, tied away behind that same minivan every morning before school? Well, hopefully not anymore. Here's a segment with Scott Minchuk talking about the drop-off zones.
Hi, this is Scott Minchuk with CDS-TV. And have you ever found yourself stuck in a drop-off zone?
The senior lot gets pretty crazy in the morning. The parents are always out there and they're always in the way. They have no sense of direction. I mean, I go there in the morning and run in the morning, and it's just trying to get out takes 10 minutes trying to back up. It's terrible. I'm sick of it.
Student drivers and their parents have the constant battle of getting to school on time and keeping traffic flowing.
I'm late constantly. My first period's a mess. I can never get there on time to do my assignments. My first period teacher's angry at me. He threatened to kick me out of his class because I'm late, just because of the parents. And to be honest, I hate it.
The reason for the drop-off zone is to help everyone get in and out of school, but too many times people disregard the signs, so what should be done about these drop-off zones? Security guards are urging parents more and more to follow the signs and cones so that student drivers will still be able to get to their spots and parents can get out of the lots quickly. Parents have to learn to use the drop-off zones and yield to the students passing through the lot and the students getting into their spaces. Students, remember to inform your parents of the drop-off zone rules. I'm Scott Minchuk, reporting for CDS-TV.
Hey, come to the Asian Student Union meeting next Monday after school in room E60. All are welcome.
Attention all robotics members. Come next Monday to room E086 and help build robots.
Hey, Aztecs, buy a thankful thought for $1 in the lunch in front of the cafeteria or in E253 and E283. They will be delivered next Tuesday.
Congratulations to the 0607 Sunrise newspaper staff for winning a Pacemaker, the highest honor awarded to a high school publication.
Earthworks is sponsoring a youth leadership workshop this Saturday at Heritage Square in downtown Phoenix. Come between 2 and 5 p.m. There will be food.
Next Tuesday during Third Hour, an associate architect will be here as a career speaker. Get your pass signed by Third Hour to attend Aztecs. Get out to Phoenix College tonight to watch the Aztecs take on the Brophy Broncos in the second round of state playoffs. Kickoff's at 7 o'clock, so be there early.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Corona. I'm Connor McAlpine.
And I'm Matt Austin.
And this was CDS-TV.